Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay, car boot season is back. I've been out over the last couple of weeks and I had no joy, but this weekend is Easter weekend, so there's quite a lot going on. We have the extra bank holidays here in the UK, Good Friday and Easter Monday. So a 4-day weekend. I went out yesterday morning, Friday morning, and yeah, it was really good, so I can't complain. So I thought I'd show you what I picked up. So I went over to the e-boot in Cozil, and I got there for about 6:15, and at that point there was just one small box of records. And when I got there, a dealer was going through the whole box, picking everything out. Great. But he did leave this behind, and I was quite pleased about that, because this is Billy Bragg's album Don't Try This at Home from 1991. Now, I'm a big Billy Bragg fan. I've never had this on vinyl. It's quite hard to get hold of, and it's quite expensive as well, you know. So to get this for £3, I was chuffed. It's a double album. Now, up to this point, Billy had put out 4 albums, all of which were pretty much just him on his own, you know. So the first 2 albums were literally just him and his guitar. The next 2 had some other bits of instrumentation on there just to add a bit of variety, but, you know, was pretty much just him on his own again, you know. So this, though, was the record company's attempt to get a hit album. So this is a full band album, you know, they're going for the big pop hits. So you've got some big tunes on here, stuff for Sexuality, Accident Waiting to Happen, and Michael Stipe features on the tune You Woke Up My Neighbourhood as well. All fantastic. But interestingly, it did absolutely no better than the previous 4. It pretty much sold the same number of records as say, the predecessors, which I suppose means that Billy Bragg sells his records to the same people again and again. I don't know, but I think this is a great album, some brilliant tunes on here, and as I say, for £3, I was chuffed with that. So that was pretty much it for about an hour or so. Then a guy turned up and put out a big table full of records, which was fantastic, you know. All the dealers got in there before me and all started picking stuff out. Nothing was priced, and when they said how much is the asked the guy how much the records were, he basically said, oh, they're all different prices, you know, so he's going to come up with a figure on the spot, which a load of dealers were put off and they disappeared, which was great, you know. So I persevered and I found a few records in there, well, a few LPs and several 45s, which I got for great prices. So first up, this is Stone the Crows, a blues rock band. I think this came out in 1970-71. First UK pressing, gatefold sleeve. Not really my bag, if I'm honest with you. I'm not a big fan of that sort of blues rock sound. But interestingly, I've been reading about this band in the week. So I'm reading Bobby Gillespie's autobiography, Tenement Kid. And he's talking about his musical influences. And a big influence on him was Alex Harvey, the incredible Alex Harvey band. And Alex Harvey's brother, Les Harvey, was in this band. And unfortunately, this band are probably best known for the fact that Les Harvey was killed on stage, was electrocuted by a microphone which wasn't earthed properly. So I've been reading a bit about this band in the week, and I came across this. I'm probably going to flip it, actually, because I say it's not really my bag, but you know, it's worth a decent amount as well, so I'll probably flip it. But yeah, not bad for a fiver. Also for a fiver, the first album by Earth, Wind and Fire from 1971. I've been after this album for years. I never see it here in the UK. I'm pretty sure that in the States you can find it quite easily for a decent price. I'm sure you get it for £15 to £20 over there, but over here it never comes up. Nice textured sleeve. Now, this isn't like the Earth, Wind and Fire that you know. So the first 4 albums weren't produced by Maurice White, they were produced by Joe Wassell. Now, those albums have a little bit more of a jazzy vibe going on. This certainly has a bit almost like a psychedelic soul, some jazz feel to it. You know, you got some really jazzy horns on this album. It's a fantastic record, and it finishes with a version of Everything Is Everything, which is, you know, probably best known for the version by Donny Hathaway. But yeah, an absolutely fantastic record in great condition, and for a fiver, I was chuffed with that. Right, and now a pile of 45s, most of which are reggae, but start off with a soul song. So this is Esther Phillips with a cover of Crazy Love, the Van Morrison tune, which is from his Moondance album, isn't it? So I don't know when this is from. It must be 71, 72. That's when roughly when Moondance came out, wasn't it? But yeah, a really nice vocal. This has been done by a few soul artists, actually. I know that around this time, Nolan Porter did a nice version as well, which is worth checking out. But pleased to find out. I think this is a promo, so you got mono version on one side and stereo on the other. And all these singles were £2 to £3 each. So There's quite a bit of reggae in there, and I did pick through it. So first up, this is Azzy Lawrence and the Carib Serenaders. Now, I picked this up because it's on the Starlight label. Now, Starlight was a label in the late 50s, early 60s that put out a lot of early R&B and early ska music. And this is a little bit ska, a little bit calypso, but a lovely 45. If you see anything on this label, pick it up. It's very collectible, you know. So I was pleased to find that for just £2 or £3. Jump up, jump up. Please, everybody jump up. Another bit of calypso. This is Byron Lee and the Dragonaires on Trojan. The tune Mr. Walker and Sunset Jump Up. I don't always buy Byron Lee records when I see them because they can be a bit cheesy. But I think anything from the sort of mid to late 60s, you're pretty safe with. And this is a really nice tune as well. Also on Trojan, The Pioneers with Poor Ramesses. Really nice vocal on this. Obviously great harmonies from The Pioneers. But the B-side, produced by Leslie Kong. It's the Beverly All-Stars and the track's In Orbit. Just a great, I suppose, skinhead instrumental. Really nice stuff. And I'll perhaps do a needle drop on that. On Randy's Records at New York, this is Pat Kelly, the wonderful Pat Kelly. He made all those brilliant rocksteady tunes in the late 60s. This is a track called Trouble in Mind, and it's backed by the great Pretender, a great double sider. But I say the main tune on there is Trouble in Mind. Absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to do a needle drop on this. If you hear a little bit of hissing, it's your ears, it's not the record. I wish somebody would come and ease my trouble in mind. Yeah, I sure wish somebody would come and ease my trouble in mind. Oh yeah. Right, okay, a couple of Toots tunes. Reggae Got Soul, just a classic song from Toots and the Maytals. I might already have that actually on 45, but that's a nice copy. And probably from a value point of view, this is one of the most valuable. This is Funky Kingston by Toots again on Dragon. Obviously, I think when it comes to that crossover of funk and reggae, it doesn't get any better than this. This is an absolutely perfect tune. Again, I might do a needle drop on that. About this label before, this is Black Wax. Now, Black Wax was a reggae label out of a record shop in Handsworth in Birmingham on the Lascelles Road. They put out records in the late 70s, and it was mainly sort of Jamaican stuff, Jamaican tunes, which they licensed and put out in the UK. And many of these were put out for the first time on Black Wax in the UK. So quite an important label. There's only about 35 releases, I think, on there. And I've been trying to collect them all. Now, this is one that's evaded me so far. This is Chant Down Babylon by Junior Biles. Fantastic tune. Unfortunately, this record is a little bit rough. Perhaps I'll try and give it another clean. But look at that label. Absolutely fantastic. Now, this is a cover of Bob Marley's I Shot the Sheriff by Negril. Now, on the Torpedo label, I was actually looking at this album. I've been trying to get a copy of this album that came out in the late 70s. It goes for about 50, 60 quid at the moment. I don't want to pay that, obviously. I don't want to pay what it's worth. Heaven forbid, you know. But I did see a copy last week, and I was trying to talk the guy down, but he wasn't having none of it. I think he had it priced at 55, something like that. And I wasn't going to pay that. But nice to find the 45 of I Shot the Sheriff for just a couple of quid, albeit the B-side does have a big scratch through it, but still nice to pick up. Okay, just a couple more. Lloyd Chalmers, great double side of this, For the Good Times, written by Kris Kristofferson. Any soul fans will probably know Al Green's version of that from his I'm Still in Love with You album. An absolutely beautiful song, actually probably one of Al Green's best performances, that. This is a nice version, but I think the other side's better. It's on here, it's titled You Are My Everything. It's actually You Are Everything by Diana Ross and Marvin Gaye. And the Diana and Marvin album, really nice version, good pop reggae version, so very cool. On the Horse label, another fantastic label, that, yeah, looking at that. And finally, something that I didn't really know, took a bit of a chance on because it's on Direction. Now, this is a bit of a, I don't know, it's a bit psyche, is it, I suppose? Elmer Gantry's Velvet Opera and the track Volcano. I like most stuff that I come across on Direction. The pressings always sound great as well. You can't go wrong, you know, stuff by the Equals and stuff like that, you know. But, yeah, really nice stuff. So I'll perhaps do a needle drop on that as well. So there you go. Cheers.